I'll take that, all that pulling the wedgie out of your pants, out of whatever.
You better, because I don't believe you. Might have to actually edit this one.
Hi, welcome to 151 Garage. I'm Sean.
I'm Jill.
And we're under the awning today. We just put it up. You'll see that in a later video. A bunch of noobs putting up awning. It's very enjoyable. Putting it back in is going to be the fun part. So it's kind of like unfolding a map. Folding it back in, you just throw it away and buy a new one.
Yeah.
So anyways.
Today's video is going to be about five things we
hate about the Bronco Sport. First thing is the auto start stop feature.
Oh yeah,
it's what a pain. It's absolutely awful. I know what it's there for, so it's there to, you know, save gas and save the environment, and I totally understand that. But there's something about the car stopping every time you come to a stoplight, especially if you're in stop and go traffic. It's the first thing I turn off, and I usually don't remember to turn it off until I get to the first stoplight and it shuts off on me, and I'm just like, reach over there, turn it off. It's a simple fix, but it's one of those things where I wish I could program it to not do that anymore.
Yeah, just have it set like a default where every time you get into the car, you don't have to press the button every single time.
Yeah,
that type of thing. That's actually an annoyance. That's both of our little tissues on it. The other one is the door locks. We have not, by we, I mean my technicians at my dealership have not figured it out yet, how to program all the doors to only where the driver's side door unlocks, like we did with the Toyota.
To give you an understanding of what she's talking about, when you open up the door on this side, basically it has that auto unlock and auto lock feature where you touch the inside of the door.
Or go on top.
Or go on top to lock it. Well, when you reach inside, it unlocks all the doors. Well, here's the issue I have with that. If there is somebody sitting on the other side of the car and you go to unlock the door, it unlocks the other side of the car's doors too. I have a problem with that because with the Toyota, a friend of ours was messing around with us and just playing around, and they got in from the passenger side when she was getting into the driver's side and scared the living shit out of her. And we're like, yeah, I took it straight to Toyota and go, you need to fix this shit or take the car back, because it's a safety feature in my eyes. Now, I guess there's a way you can shut the entire system off or it doesn't work, but that defeats the point. Why should I shut the system off? Why can't I just have it so when I touch the driver's side, just the driver's side opens? But if I touch the passenger side, all the doors open, which is basically what the Toyota 4Runner does right now. That's the way mine's set up. Now, they probably do have a way to do that. It's just this is so new, they haven't figured it out.
Yeah.
Ford hasn't.
Because I was one of the first things I asked my technicians about it. And I asked the top technicians there that we have, because we only have like three of them that are really good that can do anything. And he's like, it's so new, we don't know how to do it yet.
Yeah, so they're still trying to figure out the program and stuff like that. Again, that's a problem with new vehicles and such. They have to figure out the different programming for the computer and some of the sensors and stuff like that. So we figured that, and we're dealing with it for now. They'll come up with a way to fix it. They usually do. Again, this is more for me as a safety feature. Now, has anything like that happened to us ever since then? No. I'm looking for
prevention.
You know, is it going to happen? Probably not. Am I going to take that chance whether it happens or not?
No,
I don't want to take that chance. So I want to make sure she's safe. I want to make sure I'm safe. And when we get in the car, we don't have to worry about somebody on the other side of the car getting in at the same time.
Kind of like that thing, better safe than sorry.
Yeah, exactly. Better safe than sorry. Another thing I don't like about this for the 8 millionth time is the back window. And it's not necessarily the back window. It's basically when you open the back window, you have that hump in the middle where the latch is that holds the window shut, and the wiper motor. So you have this, looks like a giant opening, but it actually narrows down quite a bit. And I'll show you here in a second what I'm talking about. It just seems like they, I know they had to put it somewhere, but I was sitting there you know, the way we have it for the 4Runner, again, the 4Runner rolls down into the back window, so it's not the same. But we usually put our surfboards in the back of the 4Runner that way, and then put a pad across it and then strap them to that. Now, granted, we are getting a different surfboard rack for this one that is on top, not just throw it in the back of the Bronco. But we'll, I mean, it makes it really narrow compared to...
It shrinks it down a lot.
Yeah, it shrinks it down considerably. It's kind of like you having this gigantic trunk, but you have this little tiny opening you can fit stuff in, which kind of makes it irrelevant. But here, let me show you real quick. So what I'm talking about is this right here. So as you can see, this right here comes up quite a bit. And it actually blocks not really much of the view, because that headrest is usually up and it's usually blocking the view anyways. But putting anything in, this right here is a lot different than this. So it goes up a couple inches, and a couple inches counts sometimes. Don't even.
I ain't saying squat. Don't give me that. You're the one that said it. Another one was the check your rear seat for occupants every time we open the back door.
So the one thing that I've noticed, I've even noticed it because I don't get in the back seat. So she puts her purse in the back seat, and then every time she turns off the car, there's a check your occupants thing on the main screen, the basically the center screen itself.
And it don't matter if you're putting a coat in the back seat or your purse on the floor or whatever it is, that thing will pop it.
She threw her jacket in the back seat and then got in, and when she stopped the car, it threw it on there. I guess it's the fact that you open the door actually
reminds you to check the back seat for stuff.
Again, you.
It's mainly for children. They actually did it for, you know, the forgetful parents that leave their kids in a hot car.
So the last thing we have for the five things we hate is the back seat. So it's not the back seat itself. I can basically care less about the back seat because I don't sit in it. But the way it folds down. So we do have dogs and they do travel with us. And a lot of times we'll actually lay the back seat down for them to have more space. And basically it's a little bit nicer for them to lay down and such. But the one thing I don't like about this is kind of we're going to have to figure out a way to solve the problem, which is fairly simple. But when you fold the back seat down, there's a gap between the cargo area and where the back seat starts. So there's a small gap, and that's enough to get your paw in if they step in the wrong space. Now, that's a big concern with me because, again, if we're moving around and we go to stop and they slip and slip their paw into that gap, that could injure them very severely.
Break their leg.
And we don't want that to happen. We want to make sure the dogs are protected and safe, just like we are. And we can solve that by just laying basically a mat across everything. But again, it's one of those things that's kind of an annoyance for us that we want to make sure the dogs are protected. It's another added thing that we have to look at to actually buy to protect them from that. And I'll show you here in a second what that is. So right here, there's a gap right here. And when both seats are down, there's a real big gap right between basically where it fits right here. So I don't like that. What we'll end up having to do is basically get a rubber mat that goes all the way across this, or at least get something that covers this spot right here. So again, that's the five things we hate about the vehicle. They're not really bad. Like, we can't live with the hates for this. It's just kind of minor annoyances. Again, it's nothing. We would have still bought this vehicle. We absolutely love everything about it. There are some minor things. Hate's kind of a harsh word, but we figured, you know.
More annoyances and dislikes.
Yeah, dislikes about it. But nobody watches dislikes. They always watch the hates. So we'll go ahead and go with that one. And
that's it.
So we'll go ahead and...
See you next video.
Yep. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and
hit that bell.
Yep. See ya.
Bye.